As I reached this point, I just glanced in my mirrors for a second and I saw this cop car right up close behind me. So you always kind of think the worst when you see them, so I thought, nah, I'll just keep going. If he wants to stop me for some reason, then I'm sure he'll let me know. So I'm looking in my mirror every now and again as I'm driving up this road, thinking, any minute now it'll be the flashing lights and the siren or whatever. But it didn't happen. He just stayed close up behind me. So I thought, well, if he wants to get past, he's welcome to try it, but I'm not going to slow down and I'm not going to stop for him. I'm making way quite lawfully, and that's the way I intended to stay. So I'm just going up the hill now towards Milldown, and we got a weird road calming system at the top of here, where the traffic's got to give way uphill to traffic coming down, which is crazy. There's a big school on the right hand side as well. So anyway, I'm just getting through this point, then I kind of hear sirens and see, I look in my mirror again, and there's a white van, what I thought was an ambulance or a cop van, and another cop behind with his lights flashing, and the van also had flashing blue lights. So I'm just going through this road and there's traffic calming. That the pedestrian crossings have got these great big tarmac lumps, and I slowed right down. I thought, stuff you, I'm not going to wreck my suspension just for the sake of hurrying up. Nah, piss on them. If they wanted to pass me, then they had the option, but they didn't seem too keen to do that at this moment. So anyway, thinking this was like a medical thing, I thought to myself, he's probably going to turn left into Blandford Hospital, which is just up here past his turning on the left hand side. You can, as we pass it, you can see the ambulances in there, just in that forecourt bit. You can see him parked up there. So anyway, I thought he'll go in there. He didn't. So by this time the road splits, there's kind of a junction here, so I decided I'll pull over onto the right hand side of the road and let this whatever it was behind me pass. So here it comes right up behind me now. Blue lights flashing. There it goes. No cop car. The cop car that was following me is still behind me. So I'm going down through my usual route following this thing. It goes through the red lights. And I thought, that's a weird ambulance, because it's not an ambulance, it's like a camper type van, but it did have NHS, which is National Health Service, on the side of it, plus it had blue lights and a siren. So I thought, well, it's got to be a coach or something or other, but it's the strangest type of vehicle I've ever seen them use. Strictly speaking, it's definitely not an ambulance. So what the hell it is and what it was for, I do not know, but this won't be the last time you'll see this thing in this video. You will see it twice more, believe it or not, miles and miles away from here, but it appears twice more. The copper still behind me in his car, still no blue light, still no nothing, so I just ignored him this time. Going down through this bit of a road here, I'll keep the commentary going because I eventually got rid of it, or it got rid of me, whichever way you like. The road surface down through this particular road is awful. It's patchy, it's lumpy, it's bumpy. You can probably hear from the noise that's coming from the original soundtrack as I recorded on the dash cam. So we turn right here down into the main town centre of Blandford. Around this rather sharp corner into the main town, which I think is East Street, starts here. I think this is East Street. Somebody that knows Blandford well will correct me if I'm wrong. Anyway, you travel on down this road and it goes from 30 miles an hour to 20. I obey speed limits because they're there for a reason. I'm not a fast driver anyway, so I'm quite happy to do 30 in a 30 zone or 20 in a 20 zone, which is just coming into now, a 20 mile an hour zone. past the church, I don't know the name of it, or the town hall in the centre of Blandford. This is the main area. We're just coming up to, I think it's a town hall, this kind of white frontage building on the right. And there's a farmer's type of market, people selling all sorts of things. There's one guy there selling nothing but onions. So how he makes a profit on that, I don't know. It's a bit of a specialised item to sell, I would have thought, just onion. Yeah, with that little green roof tarpaulin is, I think that's the guy that sells the onions. Anyway, I dive off left here, out of the 20 mile an hour limit, back into the 30. The copper is still behind me, so I'm thinking, well, perhaps he likes me, or perhaps he likes the vehicle. So anyway, I thought if he's curious, he's certainly taken a long time to satisfy his curiosity. The van thing with the blue flashing lights, I don't know which way it went because I didn't travel fast enough to catch up to it and see where it went. It could have gone literally anywhere, but I got a feeling it came along here. We're just about to cross the River Stour now for the third time. This is the river bridge, just crossing over now. On the right is a school. Straight on is where the cop car eventually went, and I'm back travelling on my own, more or less, towards Tesco's roundabout. I always come through Blandford. I prefer this journey rather than going through the bypass. The bypass I just don't like at all. I prefer this. Plus, if I need fuel, I go into Tesco's and get the fuel. That building on the left, incidentally, we just passed, is Hall and Woodhouse Brewery. Well, we're just passing the site of it now. Quite a large brewery. They make Badger beers, amongst others. And we've got DCM Tires here on the left, just here. Great place, they're very friendly, very useful. So remember that, people, if you need a tire change or you've got a flat tire, you need a valve for your tire, which I did before the last MOT. It had a flat tire, so I went down there and they fixed it with a new valve. So that's DCM Tires. Okay, we're on the main Blandford bypass roundabout now, straight on for Poole and Bournemouth and all points south.